Hello there, everybody. This is Seawalk the Platinum One here, and welcome back to Let's Play Xenoblade Chronicles. So, last time, we rescued Melia from the Hyantia tomb. Melia's named Crown Princess now. And unfortunately, over there, the Mekon have started invading Eretz Sea. Well, if you can't even see it, but I don't know if you can see it. You can clearly see it off in a distance, actually. You can see little explosions, like, happening over there. That's pretty cool, actually. So anyway, today, we are going to the Audience Chamber to see if the Emperor has left for Prison Island yet. If he has, then that's definitely not good, because, well, 1 month ago, apparently, Alvis showed Sorian a vision in which he will die at Prison Island, and Shulk had the same vision, so we ought to go see if the Emperor is really there or not. So, let's go up this staircase, ignoring the quest along the way. And what do you have to say about this situation? Do you know an Imperial Guard named Galvin? Well, okay. I'm pretty sure that's something of note. Like, yeah, you know the guy named Galvin? Totally not related to the Mekon attack at all. It's not really part of the Mekon attack at all. First, I want to talk to you because, well, yeah. I'm sorry, I'm just talking to named NPCs like this. Well, we couldn't talk to him before, but now we can, since we have access to the Ascension Hall right now, the actual one. But, okay, whatever. Anyway, let's see if the Emperor has left for Prison Island or not. Let's go. There we go.
Brother! Where is Father?
Melia.
The Imperial Staff, it's... So Father has gone.
I...
Kallion!
The Emperor has proceeded to the island, alone. For the sake of the Empire.
Why did you let him go alone? Father!
His Majesty is fully aware.
Alvis.
Of what will happen to him, and what he must do before then.
You saw something.
I did. During our ancient divination ritual.
If he knows, then why?
Because he is the ruler of the Imperial family and all the Hyantia. We must respect his decision above all else.
But that doesn't mean...
Trust him, Shulk. His fate was decided long ago.
No!
Shulk, we're going.
But Dunban...
Respect? Destiny? We don't need rules to tell us when to save the people we care for. You too, Melia. Don't give up on him. The Emperor, your father, is going to die.
Dunban!
There's only one thing to do. Are you with me?
Of course. But you can't.
We are Homs. Do what you must. But your laws don't concern us.
My apologies, Dunban.
No apologies needed. So, Melia, what's it to be?
We go to Prison Island.
You heard the lady. We're going. I'm sorry, every time Melia says that line, we go to Prison Island, I get super excited, seriously. Like, if you couldn't tell, I am very, very friggin' excited for Prison Island, seriously. And considering this is all going up before I leave on my summer vacation, I just wanted to get to there. Just saying, right now, I just wanted to record up to that point, or maybe beyond stuff. Anyway, you may notice that I'm huffing it over there. That's because, well, skip travel is kind of disabled. So, unfortunately, we do have to indeed huff it over to, well, the main entrance to go to, well, Eretz Sea. But, before we do so, I wanna, well, at least, wait, that's not the thing. I want to at least level up Melia's arts because, well, we got a ton of, well, actually just 4 art books from Melia, actually. So I want to take that to get the summon bolt thing. Well, we don't have the art, but we are we don't have the art of Starlight Kick yet. So, oh, for the final step, that basically means we taught an advanced art book to somebody. And also, before we do that, why don't we go to Melee's arts? Because we haven't even done, like, leveling up arts in, like a while. So, yeah. Also, we got a new summon here, so I'm gonna get rid of Hypnotize for that. Actually, I'm gonna de-equip this. And I don't know if I've shown off this new one yet. According to that, I haven't, so I'm gonna freaking set that. I think I did. I don't know if I did. But if I did, I apologize if I'm going over it again. And, I'm gonna get... Yeah, Shadow Stitch, why not? So, I'm gonna get this Summon Bolt art leveled up immediately because, well... You know, we just got a level 10 art book from Melia. How often does that happen? Not very often indeed. Well, actually, it happens often if you know what you're doing, but, whatever. It just happens, man. It just happens. Now I'm going to upgrade Summon Flare, and I want to... Yeah, why not? Let's upgrade Mind Blast, because we haven't gotten to yet, and all that good stuff. Alright, let's roll. Let us roll on over to the Sea of the Aerith. The Aerith Sea. Yes, I know, I wanted to make that joke, but no, that would be too obvious. I mean, come on. Aerith Sea? Aerith Sea? Seriously, like, what possessed the freaking designers to name this area Aerith Sea? I have no idea. But they must have gotten experience from that certain popular JRPG that I can't say because then I'll get fined too much money. Anyway, now that I'm done talking about distracting things, let's head to Aerith Sea via the transporter.
This fly infestation is beginning to bug me!
Unmanned craft built by ancient High Entia. Is it too much to hope this is the last of them?
Enormous things at 12 o'clock!
Ancient creatures that were sealed within Prison Island. They have us in their sights.
They must be our target's pets.
Perhaps.
Let's see how they like this!
Prison Island is just ahead.
Do we need to use the transporter?
We do. But first, we must unlock the seals.
Seals?
We need to unlock two seals to reach Prison Island. Then, a door will appear before us, showing the way.
Got it. Move, everyone!
Path to Prison Island. Prison Island is accessible via a transporter from Central Seal Island. Open the Sister Gates, Katoral and Sultanar, which protect it, to open the transporter seal. And Sister Seals. Why they gave us this quest, I have no idea. It's just basically telling us what we already know, or what we just heard from Melia. We have to open the two seals to unlock the way to Prison Island. So thankfully, skip travel is now enabled to us, so why don't we just go ahead and do that. The shortest way to Prison Island, or if you're going to go to Prison Island, is skip traveling over to this Earth Lighthouse and moving up this way. So one thing I didn't actually show is, well, this transporter. Before, you couldn't even access this transporter. Yes. But by talking to you, the workers finally finished fixing the transporter. Now I can get where I need to go. So yeah, so remember that worker we saved, like, before Shulk got the vision that Melee was in danger in the High Entia tomb? Yeah, that worker was sent to, well, fix this transporter. but now his work is done, so now we can move on here to Hovering Reef 7. So, why don't we just go ahead and do this? Now, there are indeed monster quests that we can take care of here for right, that we could take care of for right now, like the Stella X we need to hunt. But I just want to get to Prison Island right now, if I'm going to be perfectly honest. If there are unique monsters, I am going to take care of that. But in all honesty, I don't want to exactly do, well, you know, any sort of thing with, okay, you know what? No, I'm not taking care of you yet. Reason why I don't want to actually take care of, well, any sort of unique monsters right now is because, well, we have a big story thing coming up and I don't want to miss it. Plus the fact that Eretz Sea, well, obviously, is freaking huge. And considering the fact that, well, in Xenoblade, you can pretty much go anywhere if you see it. It's going to take a very long time to complete those monster quests and Eretz Sea, and particularly those challenge quests. Yeah. So, with that being said, I don't want to exactly take care of, well, business with the monster quests at Eretz Sea or those monster quests in Alkemoth quite yet. Because, well, combined, they're just, well, take care of monsters at Eretz Sea. Go do the things. But, regardless of which, I just wanted to go over there because there was an Aether Crystal deposit right there, so we might as well take care of that and stuff. Over here, also on Hovering Reef 7, you can find these echidnas that you're supposed to hunt. But, of course, I don't want to take care of them yet. So, yeah, I'll just kind of keep running, come on. Okay, good. Speaking of Ricky and Charla and the party, actually. Ricky and Charla, as I noticed while I was linking those skills, Ricky and Charla now have green affinity with each other. Like, meaning they can link more skills, obviously. And also, I could view that heart-to-heart that I was trying to view, like, last time we were fully exploring Eretz Sea, but no. The game had to, like, dupe me on that department, no. But, whatever the case, this is Central Seal Island right here. And to the left and right are the pathways to, well, the Seal Islands that we're supposed to go. And as you can see on the, quest objectives, we have to go over there. And we have to go over here. So, obviously, we want to go over there first. Well, technically, you can do this in any order you want, but, eh, whatever. You can just, you know, do that sort of thing. So, anyway, these guys are way low-level challenges, man. They don't even know. Also, I think that's the way... Well, judging from the map, it is, I guess. Is it the way... Yes, it is. Okay. So... On the Seal Island, which, yep, it's Sultanar Seal Island. On this Seal Island, you're gonna find a pretty tough, unique monster here. The Subterranean Zomar, which is a Cromar, obviously. And also, if you look out there, you can find a monster that we need to hunt. So, yeah. Now would be a good time to show off Melia's new summon. Summon Wind! It grants agility to nearby allies. So, yeah, agility, of course, is very important. And, yeah, helps you dodge attacks and it makes you attack more often. And all that good stuff. Now, forgive me if I've gone over this art before. But I don't think I've gone over Summon Copy. It resummons the last summoned elemental, but doesn't grant the buff to it. So, yeah. Forgive me if I haven't gone over that art. Or have. But, eh, whatever the case. I do believe discharging the wind elemental will basically create sort of a blast radius in such a way that, well, it damages any enemy in the process. I think so. So, yeah. Anyway, we got a mind blast build up. Let's show what that leveled up mind blast is capable of. Woohoo! Nice. Very nice. And unfortunately, the Subterranean Zomar just freaking, resisted it. So, let's do it this time around in a chain attack. Alright, do it! Art Seal, baby! Alright, and Freezing Egg. Sarlam! Plow bam! Yeah! I love that. But anyway, now would be the perfect time to show off Sharla's art. Headshot. This is one of her more better arts, actually. In fact, it's my favorite art of the bunch. So, Headshot is very interesting. Well, not only is it, well, Sharla's most damaging art, but if the enemy is dazed, using Headshot on the dazed enemy may cause it to get instant death. So, yeah, Sharla has a pretty awesome way of dealing with enemies that are dazed. So, yeah, that is very awesome. Now it is particularly good for, like, you know, if you have a party with Topple and Daze in mind. So you can break with Shulk, Topple with Rein, and maybe if you can get a chain attack going, you could probably Daze the enemy, and Sharla will use Headshot on the thing and just freaking instant death it. Now, I'm not really too particularly sure on this, but I don't think that strategy works on unique monsters, since they're basically powerful enemies. Yeah, they're basically powerful enemies, so I don't think Headshot will indeed work on such a powerful enemy such as, well, unique monsters. I know it doesn't really work on boss fights. You may try it on, like, certain unique monsters if you want, but I highly doubt it will work. But anyway, we got another... Wow, okay, so it resists Art Seal normally. Alright, let's do it. Prepare yourself. Yeah. And now, Freezinate. And Sharla, Plow Blam, yeah, and Thunderbullet. A victory for teamwork. I love that. I love that. It sounds like Sonic Heroes in its way. It's like, I'll show you the real superpower of teamwork. Or something like that. Except, well, far less corny. Actually, you know what? Xenoblade lines can make anything sound like awesome, even if it's corny. Anyway, switching to Ricky because, well, he's got a new art to show off. It's called Burninating the Joke! Yes, Burninate. It's a blaze damaging art. So now he has another way of dealing damage over time. But here's the question. Burninate has sort of a long-ass cooldown time, even if you level it up to, like, max. Why would you want Freezinate? Well, in my expert opinion, you definitely do indeed want to keep Freezinate in there. Because, well, it has a really fast cooldown time. Yeah, especially if you level it up to maximum, because, well, basically put maximum level Freezinate, meaning Freezinate's all the time. Just saying. I'm just saying, guys. You want to keep Freezinate in there because, well, it's a damage over time art. Obviously, you'll want to keep it. But anyway, you want to beat this, Samati? I don't know what's pronounced. You want to beat this Chroma right here because, well, in my experiences with this game, I've always had it, like, go up to the top and, well, basically, if you allow this Chroma to go to the top, it's not very good for you. So, yeah, I'll show why later on. But for now, let's just take care of you. If I can freaking do this. And there we go. Alright, so let's see. Chip Talon, okay. So, where we need to head up to is we need to head up over here. It's going to be a long-ass way, by the way. So, yeah, you want to be prepared for that. And just one more away, and yep, there we go. Now, up here is where you're going to be finding more Chromars, obviously. And you'll find Arachthys Lexos, which, by the way, you do indeed need to hunt for a quest. So you might as well take care of that while you're here. So, why don't we just burninate everything? And why don't we take care of these things really quick? Oh, okay, so apparently these enemies are one of the few examples that can do chain attacks. Yeah, apparently it lighted up right there, but Melia's leveled up summon bolt is just too awesome for us. But here's the thing, though. I want to get that Rakti Lexos down here so I can hunt it. Well, reason being is because, well, it's here. We might as well take care of it. So, yeah, can you get over here, please, so Charlotte, Melia, or Ricky can freaking...
You can do it!
Go up there, please. No? Okay, fine, you wanna ignore us, then jeez. Right ahead, we'll just open up one of the seals, god. Charlotte? Oh, okay. Apparently, Charlotte was just too giddy about, you know, opening up one of the seals that she apparently fell down to her doom, apparently, so that's okay of her, I guess. Anyway, oh my god, can I think it? Okay, you know what, screw it, we're not doing it, no. If that thing wants to go away from us, that's fine. It's fine, go right ahead, I don't care. Alright. In all seriousness, we have one more seal to open up, and then we're on our way to Prison Island. So, let's go to this next transporter. And this will take us to Hovering Reef 10. Now, if you want to do a challenge quest, a unique monster that you will indeed need to hunt, the Aether is so pretty. A unique monster that will appear right here, but only at night. And that's not the unique monster. I actually have a little bit of a funny story about this. I was doing, like, the challenge quest in which the unique monster is fought here. But, here's the thing. My party members' AIs were so stupid that they got stuck on the ledge, so I had to fight the unique monster all by myself. It's really weird, like, the AI can do some really stupid things in battle, but, again, outside of battle, their AI is freaking hilarious. So it's sort of a mixed bag with the AI and stuff. But anyway, let's switch out the old pod, eh? Because, well, we've been playing as, well... freaking Ricky, as much as I would like for him to be the main character, of course he's not. Let's get in the old freaking pod, eh? Of, well, Dumban, Ryan, and Shilk, because, well, obviously, I like saying Shulk all weird. Now, be warned while you're going through Catarl Seal Island, because there is a unique monster that flies overhead, and chances are you're probably not gonna wanna be spotted by it. So, why don't we just keep on going, and yeah, you wanna keep on the lookout for the sky, because the unique monster is an echidna. And as you know, echidnas can fly. And it doesn't really look like... Oh, wait. Up there. That's a unique monster. This is Cumulus Deidenmaus. To my knowledge, you don't really need to fight it for anything, but the affinity coin is nice. Just be warned that it is indeed immune to break. So, yeah, you don't want to be up in that crap when it happens. Also, to my knowledge, it doesn't really have any sort of spike attacks, so thank God for that. Alright, so why don't we just spam arts on this thing and... Yeah, beware of its talent art, by the way. Ultra Paralyzed Blast 3. That causes paralysis, I think, regardless of whether or not you decide to shield. So, yeah, be wary of that. Anyway, we're almost up to our chain attack, so why don't we get that off? And let's do Whirly Slash. I want to do damage. Ryan time! Do it! Shulk will do the backslash. Nope. Didn't do anything. So, yeah, Tailed Gore. Oh, God. And I don't have the energy to revive. Of course I don't. Okay, then. I guess I'm cutting this until I eventually beat him? Wait, Evision. Oh, wait. Hard push. Yeah, there's a Luka can join in the fight. Yes. Okay. Come on. Get out of there. Come on. Good lord. Okay. You know what's really tough? Fighting a freaking unique monster. With those lying around. Oh my god. Get away from me, please! Go away! Jesus Christ! How long am I gonna have to walk over there? I mean, if I walk all the way over to the transporter, it counts as the auto end of the fight, but oh my god. Seriously? Okay, we're going over to... Okay. I don't know what just happened. Those things can, like, run really far distances, okay? I mean, like, I have never, like, run that far from any of those things. There were a couple of times in my previous playthroughs where I freaking lost it over the Cumulus Diamantus or whatever it's called. But, Jesus. Oh, whatever, we'll just ignore that one for now, but... Anyway, we're just gonna keep on walking by here, nothing to see here, blah blah blah, all that, and all that hooba-dooba. Alright. So, what? Oh, come on! Seriously? Okay. Yeah. So, that is the power of You Will Know Our Names, seriously. If you ever, like, hear, you know you've done, found something that will screw you over. Why don't we just get this out of the way? Why don't we just get the sealing up Prison Island out of the way? Let's just do it before I lose my shit over something else. Yeah, there you are, taunting me. I don't care, brother. You can't taunt me. There's no way in hell. Alright. So, we're up here now. Now, beware, because that Paralargos Echidna is here. So, you do indeed want to take it out. Everyone, do your best. Alright, so why don't we just do a heat haze, and we do just spam arts until whatever else happens. And apparently, according to, well, Dunban, doing worldly slash from, like, way over there causes damage anyway to the enemy, so yeah. Alright. So why don't we take care of these guys really quick, and then I will meet you guys whenever I'm done taking care of this thing. Okay, as soon as you beat that last enemy, release the seal as soon as possible. Because, well, after defeating that last enemy on the top of the seal island, this will happen. Actually, not that will happen, but you get what I mean. We completed Sister Seals, but not Path to Prison Island. Now, can I say this finally? Yep. As soon as you beat that freaking last Hoad, or enemy, these Tokos Orluga will appear to, well, finish the job. Since we need to hunt these anyway, and they spotted us, we might as well fight them. So, I am indeed going to, again, meet you guys whenever I'm done with, you know, taking care of this thing. Actually, freaking topple this thing. I know it's pretty much pointless, but I don't care, man. I just want to topple. I want to feel included. And a topple locking. And again, you're going to need those Tokos Iluga, or Luga, for, you know, Monster Quest.
Stand back! With you around, there ain't no stopping us! Totally!
Don't get cocky. Stay focused. Stay sharp.
Yes, sir!
And that's how commanding Dunban really is. Now, those Tokos Orluga will indeed drop the Orluga slacks that you need for Material Quest 3. So, thankfully, I only got one of them. Yeah, I only got one of them. But anyway, I'm going to have Rhine out in the lead this time. And I'm going to... Rhine this time! Okay, that's good. Anyway, I'm gonna have the Rhine in the lead this time because, of course, he's got the new art and I wanna show that. But, in the meantime, why don't we head back to Central Seal Island? Now that we opened up both Katurl Seal Island seals and Sultanar seals, why don't we head up this pathway and we open up the way to Prison Island? Up there. Where explosions are happening. And the Emperor is. Let's open up this seal.
Mekon! And something we've never seen before.
Big fish coming!
This is a Skyray. Presumably this is one of the creatures on Prison Island that those Mekon are fighting right now. And we clearly saw Metal Face and that Silver Mekon fighting as well. But this would be the perfect time to show off Ryan's new art, called Lariat. It attacks multiple enemies in front, so if you're dealing with a group of enemies, then Lariat is indeed a good art for you to use. But anyway, now on to, well, the Skyray itself. It's got this attack called, well, Murmur of Darkness, which I believe causes Pierce. Now, I actually forget if that's the case, because, well, I don't think I've seen Pierce on the, appearing there. It's also got Tripping Rust, which is its physical art, and, well, other such arts as well. Just be wary that if you're going to break this thing, it's gonna be pretty much impossible, considering that, well, it's a flying enemy. Obviously, it's not gonna help you out. And, oh, Aether Meteor 2! Oh, God. That forces daze on the party, so yeah, be careful of that, too. And I can't move. Yep, can't move. No, at least not until they're ready to move. Okay, Murmur of Darkness. That causes Pierce. Yeah, I was right. Okay. Now, fortunately, I'm controlling Ryan, so I got pretty much all the aggro. They can pretty much go ahead and do that. I'm just positioning Skyray in such a way that Ricky will be able to attack him from behind and get those bonus effects from Bitey Bitey and Sneaky. Alright, so I highly doubt we're going to get a chain attack to finish this off, but at the very least, oh god, Aether Meteor 2 again. Unfortunately, we don't have Monado's shield to counter that, so yeah, we're just going to have to deal with it. Alright, so we're just going to deal with it when the time comes. We almost got another Magnum Charge and Sword Drive up, so one of them would just take care of that.
Can anyone explain what this thing is?
I believe it is one of the oldest creatures on Bionis. I have only seen them as fossils, discovered around the capital. To find that they were trapped on Prison Island. Was it protecting the island?
That would imply it's sentient. I believe it's responding to something primitive.
Primitive?
It doesn't care who or what we are. Its instinct was to defend against anything, but we'll never really know.
We're losing time here. We still haven't reached the island.
Ricky, go to island!
See, guys? Ricky is just as excited as I am. He is freaking voicing my opinion as all hell. Next time on Let's Play Xenoblade Chronicles, we go to Prison Island. See you guys on the next time. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.